Welcome to part 7 of our Dying Light Developer Tools tutorial. This time, we'll show you how to add AI characters that will react to the player and move around on the map. Let's start with the nav mesh, which is crucial for every AI. The nav mesh is the multicolored area with white borders, which the AI can move around in and react to as designed. If you want to check the nav mesh of your AI, open the nav mesh window from the toolbar as seen here. In the new window, click Load to display the nav mesh. All changes in the AI's walkable terrain, like adding an object into the map, requires a recalculation of the nav mesh. So let's try it out and change something in the AI's navigatable terrain. Now you need the editor to recalculate the nav mesh. You can do it by clicking the Build and Save button. After recalculating, display the new nav mesh by choosing the Load button again. Conveniently, you can ensure that the nav mesh is always up to date when you play the map by enabling the option in the Build and Save All window. To do so, first click on the wall icon and open the window. In the nav mesh section, make sure the Build box is checked and confirm by clicking Start. From now on, the nav mesh will be automatically recalculated when you press Play on the toolbar. Okay, so now we don't need the nav mesh anymore. Let's hide it by clicking Unload. Now we can move on to spawners, or the set places where our AI enemies will show up. Remember to place spawners within the nav mesh, otherwise the AI might behave in unpredictable and incorrect ways. There are two types of spawners in the editor. The first type is for spawning individual enemies or smaller groups, while the other spawns large groups of biters. Let's start with the first type. Open the Assets window, go to the section Object Types, and find a spawner. When you have it, place it on the map. The spawner, like any other object on the map, has its own attributes. To view or change them, open the Attributes window within the toolbar, or by double-clicking on the spawner box. In the new window under the Fields tab, you can change multiple things. For example, you can choose the type of AI that spawns, for example, biters, toes, virals. You can set the behavior, such as making enemies attack you immediately after spawning. You can also determine how the AI moves outside its spawner area. Or you can determine how many AI enemies are spawned in the spawner. The other spawner type is called the crowd spawner. Let's put it on the map right now. The crowd spawner allows you to mark out a specific area for spawning a group of biters in one go. Spawners can be scaled, which changes the area available to all respective AI. Among the many attributes of the crowd spawner, you can change things like setting the difficulty of the spawner, meaning the number of zombies that fill up that space. You can adjust the density of the crowd also. So let's see how our AI works in action. And that concludes this episode of our guide. Thanks for watching, and have fun spawning your hordes of zombies.